as a graphic designer, I'm always looking at ways to speed up my workflow or just improve it in some way, shape, or form. So today's video looks at a new AI tool that I'm actually looking at myself right now, one that might very well rival Midjourney. And with tools like Midjourney, there's sometimes a limited control over the image outcomes, and the user experience can actually feel unpredictable at times. But in contrast, CGDream offers more control, making it great for creating client mockups, stock imagery, and a lot more. Now it has both a free and a premium plan, with the premium version obviously unlocking even more customizable options. But the four main features are text to image, image to image, 3D to image, which is insane, and image to 3D. And on top of that, there are a bunch of filters available to add to your results, inpainting, image upscaling, a private gallery, and much, much more, which we're going to look at very soon. But in CGDream, we type in prompts at the very bottom here, and on the right edge, we have settings for aspect ratio, how many images we want to generate, and then sliders here to control how refined, in accordance to our prompts, the outcomes are. So CGDream have recently launched the Flux Mode, and this is their next level image generation quality. And it's actually the setting I'm going to use on all of my designs today because it is the superior option. So first, let's generate an image with the text to image function. And to do that, simply type in your prompt right here. And you want to tell the AI exactly what you want to create. And for this one, I'm going to run with a 16:9 aspect ratio. And as you can see, we have a healthy looking bonsai tree. However, we can take this a step further with CGDream. And to do that, we can simply increase the resolution by clicking the 2x icon right here. Okay, perfect. But as a graphic designer, we can use this text image feature for other things aside from just simple images. We can use it to help us create or generate possible mockups. So this time, I'm going to generate two designs so I can give myself just a bit more option. And the prompt I've used is telling CGDream that I want a blank business card, and that's so I can use it as a mockup later. Now, that's looking pretty cool, but notice down here we have a brush icon. This is the Inpaint function, and we can use this to add or to remove things from our images. So just simply paint over the area of interest, and then create a prompt telling the AI what you want to achieve in this area. And there, as you can see, we have a realistic looking car key next to my wallet, just as intended. I can go ahead and use this for a mockup quite easily now in my design projects, and it means I don't have to download mockups online, and I do have total control over the appearance of my mockups. Another really powerful and cool feature is the image to image function. You can quickly upload your images right here. And for this, I'm going to come down to here and search for some filters. Let's say I want to turn this image into an alien kind of world. And once you have the filters ready, the ones you like to use, you can increase or decrease their strength here, and also dictate how much or how little you want the new image to resemble the original one. So add in your prompt and simply, well, click generate. And as you can see, this looks really cool. But here's a further cool feature. This purple and white icon here is the DreamUp function. And this is great if you're stuck for prompt ideas. So if you hit this, CGDream is going to generate an image based on a prompt it created itself. And if you see here at the very top, this is the generated prompt by the DreamUp function. And yeah, let's give this thing an upscale. So that's looking really cool, I'm sure you were going to admit. So here's another really great way to use the filters in CGDream. We can start with the filter itself, so for example here, a 3D character filter, and then place in the prompt after the fact. The filter here has really helped guide the control and the feel of this image, and it only took a few seconds to generate, and this is a really neat generation actually. So I've created a different character here, but let's turn this into an actual 3D model that we can use on platforms such as Blender. And to achieve that, simply click this icon here, which will convert your 2D design into an actual 3D model. When ready, simply click it to rotate it and position it like so. But we can do more things than just download our 3D model and use it on other softwares. We can actually convert it back into a different 2D design with a fresh new prompt. And for this, I'm going to add an anime filter. So by now you can see how easy it is to move between 2D and 3D designs with CGDream. But hey, you can even upload your own 3D models. And if you don't have access to any 3D models, CGDream does have an entire library of 3D models found right here. So let's take this guy for example. I'm going to remain using the anime filter, and I'm going to use a prompt to turn this model into a 2D manga style design. That looks pretty cool, and I'm sure you can see now how useful this tool actually is. And for me, I'm blown away by the level of control we have when using AI with CGDream. The filters and the ability to move between different functions is really, really useful. But also a side note, when you're generating your images and your designs, you can use the private button here. And this means other users will not be able to see what you make, and only you will be able to see the generations. So now is the perfect time to create and explore CGDream. And a big thanks to them for sponsoring today's video. I'm actually going to continue to explore and use CGDream because from what I've seen, it is actually really, really useful to my workflow in some areas. But of course, until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.